Hello guys, we are back again, another vlog. Today is our day for some fun. We are going on track day. We're gonna test this beast. Also, I'm going along with my friends, so we hope we will get some good times and to have some fun and so on. You see, here is a Mini Cooper S with semi-slick Duncan. Also, we have M4 ceramic brakes, another M4 stock one brakes and worn tires. Here is my friend's car which we tuned. It's Megane RS, very good track speed, so I hope we will get in this car and we will able to make some shots from inside to see how it's going. And it's full track speed, so it has roll cage, it has everything, club sport suspension, everything tuned by our company. And here is also friend with Cupra. So I hope today it will be fun and we will be all back together. Okay, stay tuned, we see there. We are here, first time at track day Grobnik in Croatia. We are here not to make record time, we are on stock P0 tires, and these tires need to last more. We will make records, we'll make records with the Trofeo R tires.
Odi do semafora dolje i onda kad vidiš zeleno slobodno kreni.
Molim?
Samo odi do semafora dolje do crvenog i onda kad vidiš zeleno kreni. Samo mi molim te, čuješ? Please, kacigu zareži.
Aha, aha.
Do crvenog i uživaj.
Hvala. Okay guys, we are ready. Let's see how this car behaves. biti sam ekspert u ovome auto što se tiče toga.
Meti je.
Nisi zatvorio priko vrata.
Aha, dobro. Vrata je navika na Megana njezoga.
E, prika slika. Idemo.
Aj, moramo upali pa nek snima. A upalja si ti već? To već radi, pitaj Boga brat kako
ne, 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 samo nek snima. Napnik kod da dolaziš pun gas.
E, znam.
Tu je odatle ga već krenio otvarat prema unutra. Da se prekoči auto.
Yeah.
Auto se ukupa. Baš treba naučiti kočiti. Jer ti si ono kako smo radili svi na one stare kožnice, ovaj auto baš dozvoljava da.
Jel me brave zajebavali?
Ne. Nije. Hajmo sve i daj, znači to bliže pasamo što možeš. Ovdje slobodno i daj, pušta ga lipo skroz do kraja druga. Znači samo što gledaj da što više vremena provedeš dok je bolan ravan. Tebe auto baš dozvoljava kočiti ono.
Da, da,
old ABS, yes. Dobra, evo, tapkaj poču.
Finish, guys, track day for today. Stock tires are shit. We have no pressure, but they are too hot. We have a very low pressure, but they are too hot and impossible to get it cold. And it's enough for today. We have tested the car properly and soon I will get you back. So we are finished for today. Car is good, we have tested all, check the tires. We didn't kill it a lot, so still usable on the street. But tires are, to be honest, the weakest part of this performance car. Suspension, drivetrain, it's amazing, it's brilliant. Brakes never got fade, and I was braking with 240 kilometers. It's brutal, brutal. Just tires. Tire. Just tires are weakest part. We dropped the pressure, but still 70 degrees of Celsius temperature, and just car is sliding. Next time for track, we are with Trofeo R tires. See you guys. Okay, track day is over. We are going back from trip, and just to tell you a few things about the car and what I do like, what I don't like, and which I was amazed by, and so on. So today it was my first track day with new RS3. I was there before with my old one. Car is full stock, stock tires, and like I said, I don't like these tires and they are not matching the car. Let's go with the amazing things. First, most impressed by its brakes. Guys, you need ceramic brakes on this car. Who is fast driver going on track? You need these brakes. It burned every penny of it. I was braking today from 240 kilometers on the track to the 110-20, so it's big brake zone, and brake never fade. It was amazing, pedal was firm, consistent. To be honest, brake is too hard for this car and this power. In the beginning, and still practicing, I overbrake because car is braking so well that you need to brake later. But what is the issue? When I did one or two laps, I can brake later, but issue is that then the tires cannot grip, so I'm sliding. I am braking, brakes are firm, hard and strong, but car is sliding. ABS is working because tires have no grip, so it's hard to get balanced when something is perfect and it's not matching another hardware. So brakes 10 of 10. Tires, okay, we will be later about that. Let's talk with good things first. So brakes 10 of 10. Next is suspension. I was using performance mode. I tried the dynamic and I tried the balanced in individual mode. To be honest, car is the best in the performance. In dynamic, it puts for me a bit too much power for the rear, so it's alive to the back, and I don't like that a lot, especially if you are in curve with 120 miles. That's not a good feeling. And the best was in performance. In individual, it was neutral, but it was more like old RS3. It wasn't so sharp, alive, responsive, direct, and so on. So I was using performance modes. Suspension is perfect. After the finish line, we have one big jump, and it's really unpleasant. Lots of cars on coils jump around on that bump, and you hit that bump with 230, 40, 50, 60 kilometers. So yes, it's risky to do that, but on this suspension and performance, you don't feel the bump. Car is firm, rebound is fast, car is not going left and right, it's stable, but you don't feel the bump. So for me, it's amazing suspension, works every penny, and also suitable for track. I was amazed how it worked there. And the latest thing is torque vectoring. Torque vectoring is, like I said in the video before, phenomenal. It's really working different, and you need to learn how to drive this car. My friend also, Ante, helped me a lot, which you can see in the video. I was with him in Megane. Helped me a lot, and he gave me a few tips how to start with this car. And the main thing is in curve, you need to have throttle. You cannot let off the throttle, even if you are too fast. If you are too fast, you give a bit throttle, and you rather give more movement with steering than releasing the throttle. If you release, you go out, and this torque vectoring is not working like that. So if you want that rear, let's say we go left, and if we are sliding out, we need throttle. camera goes to the right rear wheel and it goes like that. And nose is pointed to the apex of the curb. So yes guys, it's something different league. It's working amazing and this car is a beast. Just when everything is good and engine, yes, enough power, we are getting good time on the straights. So it's really not so slow, to be honest, on straight line for stock car. So everything is okay, everything is good. I love it. Tires are shit, I need to tell it, really really bad. One lap they are good, and that is the warm-up lap. And what happens next after one lap? Tire pressure goes up, let's say 2.8 bar fronts, and then temperature of tire rises to 50-60 Celsius, and after that tire is not working anymore. Tire is just loose, car is sliding, you can have torque vectoring and whatever you want, but it's not helping because car is going sideways over the nose a little bit. So with these tires you can only do, let's say, two fast laps and that. But what is the issue then? I was driving like that, I was getting out and I drop pressure to, let's say, 2.2 bar 2.3, so I have room for increase. But the issue is the temperature of tire is not dropping no matter what I do. So I don't have pressure, tires are soft but warm, so they are sliding again. And it's never happened with, let's say, cup 2 tires or something like that. So these tires, you can do 2-3 circles, stop for half an hour, then back again. So yes, definitely not track tire, and definitely it's not getting best of this car. Conclusion, very very happy. I have managed to do time 143.9 seconds. To compare the time, I believe one of the fastest stock car hatchbacks, let's say my old RS3 with TTA 700 with Bilstein and Cup 2, I was doing 140.8, so I was 3 seconds faster, but much more power and everything, and much better tires. So I believe this car will get that time with just Trofeo R tires. That would be great. Guys, I hope you liked our nine videos. I'm trying to do my best to share with you experience so you can easily decide to buy or not to buy, or if you have no possibility to get this car, then you just share with me some my experience and that you can have that feedback from first hand. That's all guys, I'm very happy with car. Consumption is great on freeway, normal driving, it's good on the track, everything is good. Now with 2800 kilometers you can hear more sound, the sound of exhaust will be next video, but I was waiting to get a few miles to burn a bit, like you've seen on my page on Instagram.